Watch your tongue.
Maker.
Thank you, Your Holiness. Now, Artigan, as to your concerns.
The Inquisition established an armed presence in Ferelden territory. You outright seized Cair Bronach in Crestwood.
Our goal was to keep more Ferelden citizens from dying, not to seize power.
Your help was appreciated 2 years ago, Inquisitor. Now order has been restored, yet you remain. Invading under pretext of restoring order is exactly what the Grey Wardens did to us centuries ago, and we exiled them. Now the Inquisition is doing the same thing with Grey Wardens in their ranks.
Your concern is ill-founded. The Grey Wardens have proven their worth time and again.
Of course Orle tolerates this interference. The Inquisition is the only reason Selene still has the throne.
Rest assured, Tegan, the Empire of Orle will not stand idle if the Inquisition oversteps its bounds. Unlike Ferelden, however, Orle understands that these were the well-intentioned mistakes of a young organization.
An organization in need of a guiding hand. Yours, no doubt.
Pardon me, Inquisitor. Divine Victoria wishes to speak with you in private.
Divine Victoria? Who is sitting just up there?
Yes, and who was once your spy master. It's a pressing matter, Your Worship.
My apologies. An urgent matter has come to my attention. Ambassador Montelier, can you handle this for a short while?
Of course, Inquisitor.
This is highly irregular.
Perhaps it would be best if we took a short recess. The guard said we should both see this. I believe she was correct. A Canary warrior in full armor. How did he get into the Winter Palace? Would the Iron Bull know anything about this? I asked, and he is as surprised as we are. He says that if this were an official Canary operation, he would know. That suggests we're dealing with a rogue faction.
So, what would the Left Hand of the Divine see when she looked at this?
This is a warrior, not a spy. Part of the Antam, the Canary military. Most of his wounds come from a fight against someone using magic, but at least a few are from a blade. He was badly hurt, separated from his allies, and made it here before he died. But how?
We need to find out what's going on. Can Josephine manage the diplomats while I look around?
She will be fine. It's all speeches and posturing for the first few days anyway. I will extend the recess as long as possible. I will also have our friends ready themselves for battle if need be.
You think that's likely?
I think the Exalted Council may be more exciting than we expected.
Like he came down over the railing. going through it, I'm not going alone. Crossroads. Morrigan brought me here while showing me the alluvians. Judging by the bloodstains, he tried to get through here.
Is something wrong?
This mirror doesn't look broken, but it's inactive. Maybe there's a way to unlock it.
Let us see where this Kunari came from.
Elven ruins. I'm not sure we're even in Orle anymore. Another Kunari, dressed like the one in the Winter Palace.
They must be from the same faction, both girded for war.
Scorch marks everywhere. This is the work of a mage.
The expended energy is remarkable. I'd say the spell was cast within the past hour.
We need to find out why these Kunari were here and who did this to them. Over there, Kunari. If we want to know why they're here, we've got to get across to that island.
Tisha Valem, Fenharer Alavadra.
A spirit bound when the elves built this place, because that could never go wrong.
What does it want?
Nuvenas Menahelan, Dias Belasama.
We're visitors. We didn't mean to disturb you.
Vithama, Nadinan Sabid.
Intruders.
To be fair, we are.
It must have been set to guard something. That was like Veilfire. It claimed this was a refuge for elven slaves.
You mean the ancient elves kept slaves? Maker's breath. One more thing never to tell Daisy.
This whole valley was a sanctuary created by the Dreadwolf Fenherel. Curious, then, that the Dalish speak of Fenherel as a monster. That alluvion only took us a short distance. That's the same lake we saw from the other tower.
So the old elves had many uses for these devices. Wounds on the back, no blood on his sword. Someone took him by surprise.
This can't have happened too long ago. The blood's not even dry.
So, we're getting the band back together. That's exciting.
We are not a band of any sort.
Just because you can't carry a tune, Seeker, doesn't mean you're not front and center in our band of misfits.
Fen'Harel helping former slaves as a mortal, not a god.
He took great pains to renounce his supposed divinity.
Ordinary guy saves people, accidentally founds religion. Sounds a lot like the chant, actually.
To the Dalish, Fen'Harel is the great deceiver. Perhaps that's propaganda begun by the opposing gods. The elven gods were just Evanuris, powerful, but completely mortal mages.
Was this the start of an uprising? Freed elven slaves against their former masters?
If that's true, Fen'Harel was teaching these freed slaves the truth about these false gods.
Okay.
The anchor's flared up. It's fine now. This looks like it fits into that pedestal by the broken bridge.
This place is horrid. sorry.
The Inquisition doesn't leave alive.
Thank you.
Why did those Kunari attack the Inquisition on sight?
Kunari never act without orders. A commander in the Kun must have given them.
Are you saying the entire Kunari nation wants us dead? Darling, leave that to me. That's Sven Harel, removing the face markings from a Dalish elf.
Isn't this place older than the Dalish?
Maybe the markings used to have a different meaning. Hidden weapons. These freed slaves actually fought back against the Evanuris, posing as gods.
Elven mages who hoarded power and slaves? One could see parallels to Tevinter's magisters.
Inquisitor says the Kunari came to these ruins because the alluvians connect to Halam Shiral.
A staging ground? For an invasion?
It was some sort of infiltration. There's no more details.
You know, darling, this place gives me an idea for redoing the small summer breakfast room at Chateau Ghislaine.
You have a different breakfast room for every season.
A century ago, it was in fashion to have a different room for every meal and every day of the week. When that fad ended, the Dukes of Ghislaine converted most of the rooms to closets. Storage is timeless.
It's been too long since we've traveled together. I've missed it.
Aw, oh, you missed me.
It. I said I missed it. Oh.
A note about an unknown intruder coming through an alluvian. They turned spirits against us, then fled.
A mage? They must have fought their way out, then let the spirits finish off the Kunari.
Two parties, then. The Kunari, and a mystery agent determined to stop them. Come on, we have to warn people about the Kunari's designs on the Winter Palace. letter by the Kunari. Why are they translating it into our language?
Thank you. One dead Canary was bad enough. Now we have more, and they're hostile.
This makes no sense. The Canary may not be friendly to the Inquisition, but they have no reason to attack us.
They also have no reason to be here, or using Illuvians at all.
I've had the mirror placed under guard for now, Your Holiness.
Cullen, please just call me Liliana.
Yes, Liliana.
I just wanted the Exalted Council to go smoothly. We must ensure that the Canary do not disrupt the negotiations. The Exalted Council is in a very delicate state.
I'm certain you can soothe the nobles' ruffled feathers while we solve the real problem.
Not when the Inquisitor insults everyone present by walking out in the middle of the talks. Our only advantage is that Orlais and Ferelden are divided in goal and grievance. If they unite against us, Divine Victoria will have no choice but to support their claims. We could lose everything.
I know we're asking a lot of you, Ambassador. I promise we won't make this any harder for you than necessary.
My apologies. I will attend to the Exalted Council.
And while Josie does that, we will investigate.
We, Your Holiness?
You do, Josie?
I'll head back to the crossroads. We need to find out what the Kunari are doing and why they attacked.
And I'll have a quiet word with our honor guard.